Who doesn't love a good rom-com? What's better than watching two people fall in love with each other right in front of our eyes, watching their relationships develop from enemies to just friends to just friends to what are we? It really warms my heart when I watch these kinds of movies because I am a firm believer that one day I too will receive a rom-com romance. Little did I know that this day would arrive earlier than I thought. And here is a little story that had me thinking rom-coms must be based off something true, right? After a few months of trying to find interesting, charming guys on Tinder who are able to hold conversations, I thought to myself, ah, alas, Ku, this is it. You are going to be single for the rest of your life. You will get no awkward cute dates, and you, my friend, are going to be a lonely cat lady who's actually allergic to cats, so you're just gonna be a lonely lady. Until fate had brought this really cool guy back into my life. I had Tinder, I deleted it, and then re-downloaded it, and then I deleted it again. But the guy that fate brought back to me befriended me before I deleted it the first time. So he messaged me randomly one day, and we just started talking and really hit it off again. We never really ran out of things to talk about, which was so refreshing. And the one thing that we had in common was that we both had foreign parents, so that just one thing kept us laughing for hours and hours. He eventually mustered up the courage to ask me out, which I think deserves a round of applause. If you guys have ever asked anyone out, that, like, I've never done it before, but I can imagine it being the scariest thing ever, asking someone out, like, you're just like, here, take my heart, but please don't break it. But yeah, so he asked me out, and he did it in the cutest way, and he used the word smitten, which I never thought that, like, could be used in, like, the English language other than in songs. So we go on our date, and it's, like, one of the nicest dates I've ever been on. He's a real gentleman throughout the night, and it was straight up from, like, a rom-com set. He picks me up at, not at my house, just because I don't want my parents to, like, see, and, like, now my parents know because it's on the internet. Anyways, so we have dinner, and then we go out for coffee. Well, I don't get coffee because A, I'm old, and B, I'd be like jumping off the walls. After coffee, he drops me off at a different location, and then I walk home. And to most people, this sounds like a perfect date. And we both mutually agreed that a second date was in the talks. Fast forward 2 days later. I get off work, I spend the afternoon with my parents because it's like a holiday, and BJ calls me. He and I live in different cities, so we don't really get a chance to like talk on the phone except for like at night before we go to sleep. And yeah, I put my phone down for a bit because my mom had asked me a question, and then he dropped the bomb. Well, to other people, it could be a huge bomb, but to me, it was just like, So he had explained to me that he went to a party the previous night and his friend had confessed that she was in love with him. They've been friends for a really long time and they both kind of liked each other but never found the right time to say this to each other. And since I'm a true believer of fate bringing two people together and time being that like annoying little thing that stops it from happening, I wasn't gonna be a part of that. And then I thought, oh my gosh, this happened to Mindy Lahiri on the Mindy Project, and shout out to Mindy Callen. Hey girl, you do you, you keep rocking it. You are so awesome. Okay, other than that. So I thought to myself, oh my gosh, am I Mindy Lahiri who helps BJ Novak's character and Lucy find their love with each other? Heck yeah, I am. So before anyone starts saying, oh, poor Ku, Ku, you are such a nice girl. Girl, if it's me, I would be able to do that. First of all, I don't want anyone to feel sorry for me. It did like hurt a little bit, but all I could think about was like the bigger picture. What if this time was the right time for them? Because before it obviously didn't work between them two. Am I gonna stop that from happening? If the roles were reversed and I was receiving the confession from my friend, I would like to believe that BJ would react the same way as I did. It was a little sucky for me, like I said before, but if these two end up falling in love with each other and getting married, I played a role in their love story. There are so many other things I took away from this experience. For so long, I was so terrified of dating, like, generally, but that can be, like, a whole different, like, vlog, so we'll just push that away there. But Yeah, through this I was able to overcome the feelings of like rejection and the feelings of like exposing who you are to someone and being terrified that they're not going to accept you for who you are. They're going to be scared of the things that you like, and they're just going to make these judgments about you before even getting to know who you are. One other thing that I was able to kind of take away from this was that I think now I am ready to let someone like me for all of me, the pretty sides, the ugly sides, the things I'm really good at, the things I suck terribly at, my goals and my ambitions, the things that scare me the most. But yeah, so to all those who say rom-com situations never happen in real life, well, guess what? It happened to me. I am not some kind of romantic lead in a rom-com or Korean drama. You know, I'm just like a girl who's looking for her next adventure and someone to share it with. But